Hey, BrainStuff, Jonathan here. Every year I attend CES, an annual event highlighting the newest cutting-edge technology in everything from autos to television. And when we're talking about TV, we're talking about one big thing, resolution. In just a few years, we've seen the race move from 720 to 1080p to 4K and beyond. And this brings us to today's question. Does TV resolution matter? Spoiler alert, the answer is yes, absolutely. Or maybe a better way to say it is yes, absolutely, asterisk. Before we get to all that weird stuff that asterisk represents, we need to understand resolution itself. Resolution starts with the pixel. A pixel is the smallest possible unit of a digital image, a single point of light. When you hear manufacturers talking about resolution, they're describing the number of pixels on a given screen. So an old school cathode ray TV would display the equivalent of 300,000 pixels on the screen, while an HD TV could pack more than 2 million pixels into the frame. The standard way for TV makers to classify resolution is with numbers followed by a letter. The numbers indicate the rows of horizontal pixels, so think 480i, 1080p, and so on. The bigger the number, the more pixels on the screen. The letters at the end of the numbers stand for interlaced and progressive scan. The differences are important, but fairly complicated, so let's save that for another day. Using more pixels to form an image creates a smoother, less blocky, or pixelated image. So at first glance, it sounds as if more pixels equals a better experience, right? Not so fast, slick. Here's where our asterisk comes in. Pixel density itself is not the only factor in the race toward a better, sharper image. If we're looking at resolution as the ability to discern fine details, several other factors come into play. For instance, what's the source of the image? What role does color play? How close or far are you from the screen? And how big is the screen? If you're watching a small enough screen, say, 26 inches from 10 or more feet away, your eye won't be able to tell the difference between anything from 480 to 4K. The farther you are away from the image source, the smoother the picture appears. As for the size of the screen, well, sure, you could have a 26-inch TV with 1080 line resolution, and it would still have the same number of pixels as a 55-inch TV with otherwise identical specs. But the pixels would be physically smaller. So in this context, size definitely matters. If you put a 26-inch HD TV with 720 line resolution next to another 26-inch HD TV with 1080, you may not be able to tell a difference between the two. These are just a few of the pertinent factors in the overall equation. There's another big question here too. Does the human eye have a resolution limit? It is true that after a certain point, the human eye is unable to notice or appreciate the differences between some pixel densities. With the right source material, equipment, and viewing distance, 4K really can make a difference. For example, if you're sitting a few feet from a 60-inch 4K television with an ultra-high definition video feed, you'll be able to tell if someone suddenly switches it to regular HD, or brace yourself, standard definition, ugh. The limits of HD TV aren't a failure of technology, they're a limit of biology. If we can't tell the difference between a lower resolution 26-inch TV and an HD version, then there's not much incentive to buy the latest ultra-high definition TV set. But this isn't the end of the story. The race for higher resolution continues. Cameras that shoot in 4K have already become the norm, and each year brings new innovations. These ultra-high definition technologies may not make for a better picture on a home television, but in a movie theater, it makes a big difference. And in the future, we might not care as much about resolution. It's possible that other technologies, like high dynamic range, may become the next big thing. Thanks for watching! If you'd like to calculate the optimal TV size, resolution, and viewing distance for your home, look at the description. We've got a neat guide made by CARLTON, BALE. And check out this video for more information on emerging ultra-high definition technology. In the meantime, I have a question. What do you think about the future of TV technology? Where should it be headed, and is it going in the right direction? Let me know in the comments, and as always, stay tuned for more BrainStuff.